Hello, so let me share a few tips with you. First of all, there is fast traveling in the game, and to fast travel you only need to find one of these campfires over here. They are found all over the wilderness, so yeah, fast travel is something that you must unlock sooner or later. So when you are near this camp over here, it's called an outpost. You can travel to any campfire that you have lit, so that means I can even go, let's say, to here. And you may be wondering, why is that important? Because certain areas have certain resources. For example, this area has wolves. Is that a resource? I don't know, but it's there. And you'll need to find, let's say, buffaloes can be here. And on this area there can be a forest biome where you find some tea leaves, which are helpful, because you can craft a healing potion with that. But let's just go. By the way, this is a save point and also a rest point, so if you want it to be nighttime, so you will... whatever, this kind of happens sometimes. So the best way to sneak is, of course, during the nighttime. And if you do this, you'll just sleep a little bit and then you'll be ready for action, because it will be nighttime. So let's go to my main base. And your main base will have 8 max warriors, and the other ones will usually have 4. And now time for some quick base management tips. Again, this game has a very steep learning curve, but if you play enough, you'll learn enough. And another thing that's interesting is that this is a single player game that has an integrated social function in it. So, what does that mean? Well, first of all, let me ride my horse. Oh, that patrol is so close to me. By the way, to tame horses, you just have to run in them into the rocks or somewhere they can't run. Then click F for mount and then just hold G. G as in, I don't know, whatever. I can't think of anything that starts with G. So let me show you how to tame a horse. Of course, it's better if you have one of the horses with you, but you should be able to corner them pretty fast. Okay, no one actually took the bait, so they're just running around. But it's pretty easy usually. You just have to make them run against the cliffs like that. And then you can go and just, I don't know, tame them. And this is your little tribe over here. So they equip all the weapons that are available for them in their storage. And they usually seem to pick the stronger weapons, like a very good bow or a rifle. Now, about the storage items. So, if you are in the area, you can just click on your main camp or whatever camp you have. For example, if you had this camp, you could click on it. And then you can just put items in your camp, even though you are very, very far away. So, let's put some of these. Usually, I keep this one. By the way, the game doesn't really tell you if the ammunition is balls or cartridge. Yeah, this is not a good... What was that? Scarface. Yes, Scarface had the thing with the balls. So this is kind of like a quick menu to do it. 0.58 caliber. Sure, put those in as well. Meat is also very good for that. And now let's say you want to take something out of your inventory. Again, you can be anywhere on the map. That is, the game lacks a proper sorting. So most of the time you will be stuck doing something very, very silly. Now, to get my 4.41 caliber, you just have to take it like this. You can take everything, but I usually don't take more than 12 bullets because that's a little overkill in my opinion. And now... Again, this is part of your understanding of the base game. So that we cover the inventory management, what can your base do? Well, it can attack a settlement. That can be very, very useful, because later in the game you can just send your warriors to attack them, but in the beginning, no, don't do that. They can settle, which means they can create another camp, because as you can see, this has a max of 8. But again, settling a new area is very hard. I don't recommend you try it, at least until later. You can click, for example, yes, but you'll need a lot of warriors. And also they need resources, so that's not something you'd really want to do. Tame horses. Hay bait. Yeah. You can actually just go and tame all the horses yourself because I showed you how to do it. You just need a good pair of cliffs in your area. Patrol. This is also very, very important. Because you can make the... Select your camp. Select that. And then you can just add more people. And then don't forget them to give them weapons as well. And now the most important thing your camp can do... Of course you can upgrade it, and this is why I said it's important. For example, you find boars over here, deer over here, buffalo over here. So you need those skins to upgrade all your camps. So that can take a while. So the most important thing they can do is of course gather. By the way, they need meat every day. So the game says that each warrior needs one meat every day. So to send them, let's say, hunting, click on the gather. You can send almost all your warriors, but one has to always be in the camp, otherwise the camp fails and you lose all your inventory. So yeah, if you lose all the warriors in your camp, that's basically game over for your camp and you lose the items in there, so don't try that. Again, sorry about the longer explanation, but before you understand the basics, you have to understand the very, very basic things. For example, let's have three warriors gather meat. You can make them take the horses. I think I have three horses. And it will tell you, they need bows. So I'll just give them, let's say, the regular bows, not the high quality ones. The high quality ones, actually, it's not important how the bow is, it's important the arrow they use. So for 9 extra damage, that's not really worth it. So we have three warriors, we have three bows, we have three horses. And then you need to give them arrows. That means regular arrows. Some people say that you only need to give them a few arrows, but let's just play it safe and very, very role-playing. And let's say we'll give them 30 arrows, 10 for each of them. What? Why can I click send? Okay, no horses then. Because apparently my horse was not in the stable. Okay, let's do it the proper way then. To put a horse in the stable, you just need to take the horse and put it in the stable. And then I'll send the rest of my warriors to gather another important resource, which is wood. Okay, now they have three horses. You can also close the gate if you want. Anyway, it's a bit buggy, but again, it's early access, so what do you expect? It should show you what the amount of horses you have somewhere on the... Here, it is two horses only. I don't really understand why I have two horses, because it should be free. Two out of eight. Anyway, that doesn't matter. As I said, you can just put some... tame some horses. So now... Another example would be to send them for wood, because that's another important resource. By the way, see that some of options are not available right now, because they are not in the area. So that's why you need to constantly expand to get access to all your resources. The enemy will do the same. So wood is good for bows and for arrows. So let's send three warriors again. But since we don't have... three horses, let's just send two of them with horses. And there it is. Now, another very, very important aspect is that you can see they are here gathering stuff. So if you see a patrol, you'll also see their icons on the map, but I think they didn't left or something. I don't know, the game is weird sometimes. So see, this is the warrior icon. They didn't leave the camp for whatever reason. Oh yeah, they actually show you how they do it. Let's watch them gather some wood. I don't know where those other are. They should show on the map. So if you see a patrol and they are nearing your icon, your warrior icon, you can just click cancel. I guess they gave up because there was no meat to hunt in this area, because I kind of kill everything, so yeah. The other warriors are back. And do they have meat with them? wish they this was auto sort, but no, it doesn't auto sort. So yeah, they kind of fell because either there was no meat in the area or something else happened. So again, that's why you need to expand. If you click cancel, they'll just come back to base, but we'll just leave them together a few things for now. And another important thing is that you have here the skills, the social skills. Actually, let's talk about this. If you play on social, it's an option. This means you'll be online and you have a chat. So if you don't know, let's say you don't know how to. Actually, let's look for a good question. Should I make camps near my old ones or further so I can teleport? Use outpost. I mean, you can use outpost for teleporting, so that's not really needed. And he basically said you should actually do it slowly, expand very, very slowly, build a camp, and then fortify your area, and then go for the resources that I mentioned. So, yeah, it will be in your best interest if you just explore everywhere on the map and just light up all the fire on the outpost. So you can teleport everywhere on the map, especially on the parts with the rare resources. Yeah, that's kind of a problem, right? Also, you have here take SPs. It will give you some skill points. Not a lot, but it can add up over time. So be sure to click that. And here on your chieftain skills, if you have problem, this is your karma. I know it's kind of hard to tell. So if this is near red, it's bad. You have bad karma. For example, you have tribe gathering, improved hunting, gathering, and leadership. So, if you have those skills leveled up, and many people say you should level them up first, then your warriors can actually gather interesting stuff and rare stuff. Or you can get one more warrior when a new group arrives. You should be getting a new warrior once every, I don't know, 2 or 3 in-game games. That depends on some other factors sometimes, but usually when 2 or 3 days pass, you get a free warrior. And he'll bring a bow or something else. But yeah, you need to upgrade these skills. You can also make them craft something. For example, make them craft 10 arrows. 20 arrows, actually. So that will need 20 wood. So let's confirm that. That patrol is again getting very close. So if you want to decrease the number of patrols, this is not confirmed, but I just noticed it. If you destroy their camps, they'll stop sending patrols in those areas. Right now I need to go there to Fort Airminster and kill that base. Another interesting thing is that, of course, you have your skills and your crafting. If you unlock, let's say, a better bow and don't use the wooden bows, they are so bad. At least unlock the hunter's bow, and then you'll get the sinew-backed bows, which are kind of random in parts of the map, or just random loot on the enemies. In the bases of the enemies, like the fort or the deserter camp. Anyway, you can find a lot of useful loot. It's hard to explain what this game is because it's hard if you don't have a question. So if you have any questions, just post in the comments. But this is basically the basic stuff you need to know to get yourself going. I also have another video where I show how to stealth and how to kill and how to do some other things. As for your gear, as you can see, this is what I really have. Since I don't have any healing items because in my area I don't have anything to heal with, this is kind of what with I'm stuck. But yeah, you should search the mixed potion, the rejuvenation, and the healing potions. And if you have tea in your area, which someone said it's in the forest area, then you'll be all set. If not, well, there is a work around it. Just pick the ability, the health regeneration perk. And if you don't know what to choose after that, you can also get the backpack capacity, health regeneration, bow accuracy is kind of important too. Or some other ones, stamina, etc. Just look at them. They are all so good. Also, this one is kind of good. But the only ones that really make sense, in my opinion, is the backpack capacity, the regeneration, and then you can go after the chief skills. The hunter ones are good, but it's not that good. It's not as good as the other ones. And besides, you should always have your tribe gather the resources you need. Let's see what else they can gather in this area. Boar pelt. Yeah, we have no boar seal. Probably they will search the lands, but if they don't find anything, they'll just retreat. Anyway, this is kind of the basic things you need to know to learn the game. See you next time. Bye.